Hello and welcome. As you may know, the advanced C function block supports importing C source code files, letting you execute code developed by a third-party tool in real time, on a HIL device. With the 2023.2 software release, we have one more file type which can be imported into the Typhoon HIL environment. C archive files, or .a files, are a special file type that ensures the model is optimized for Typhoon HIL ARM processors. This is mainly useful in cases where models are shared between companies, and preserving IP is very important. In these cases, it is not convenient to send source code files in a human-readable format. C archive files allow you to pre-compile models developed in other simulation tools for Typhoon HIL's ARM processor during model export, letting you exchange models across software while keeping your IP protected. Let's briefly review how C archive files work in practice. When we compile C source code, we select the compiler type, so that compiled file can be loaded to and run by a specific device. Since HIL devices use ARM-A9 or ARM-A53 compilers, we want to use a compiler type that would generate files appropriate for those Typhoon HIL devices. After compilation, object or .o files are generated. After these files are generated, and if the proper compiler is used, we can archive them as C archive files and import them into the advanced C function block. Now, let's see how you can convert source code to C archive file. Here you can see multiple C function files present, with their appropriate header files. As the names of these files suggest, these codes perform subtraction, summation, and incrementation. The first step is to compile all source code files into object files. For this, we'll use a compiler provided by Typhoon HIL for ARM. Different HILs use different ARMs, so in order to check which compiler you should use, please visit the System Architecture page in Typhoon HIL Software Manual. To find the exact path where these compilers can be found, also please visit Advanced C Function page in the Typhoon HIL Software Manual. Now, let's compile the files. That we have generated object files, we can combine all object files in one archive file. It is important that archive file contains the lib prefix. For generating the archive file, we'll need a slightly different command. As before, the exact path for this can be found in the advanced C function documentation. Now that we have generated C archive files, we can include them in Typhoon HIL software. For the purpose of this demo, we have created a model with an advanced C function block. First, let's go to the Library Import tab. There, in the bottom of the dialog box, we can include the C archive file. Since we have compiled this for a HIL 606, and this HIL device uses an ARM-A53, we will mark this in the bottom text box. Additionally, we also have to include the header file so that we can call the functions during code execution. For this, let's go to the Additional Sources tab, where we'll import them. Now, let's adapt the main code so we call one of our predefined functions and adjust the interface of the component. Now we can compile the model. Now that we are in SCADA, let's change the input values to validate the code we imported. As you can see, outputs are according to the system input. We hope you find using C archive files useful for sharing your models and control code in an IP-protected way. Thank you for watching.
Check the video description for more resources on this topic, including how to download and get started with Typhoon HIL Control Center for free. You can also visit hil.academy to access free courses, expand your HIL testing skill set, and get certified. Subscribe to our channel to get notified about new content.